We're going to continue our worship and song.
Just good enough, Miss Just Good Enough, I have a warrant for your arrest.
What's the charge?
You're being charged under Romans, Article 6, Section 23. You are a known sinner, and you are continually falling short of God's desire for your life.
You gotta be kidding me.
No, I haven't. Mrs. Good Enough, I must read you your rights. You have the right to remain silent. Anything you say will be held against you. Will be held, can be used against you in a court of law. I must read you, you have the right to an attorney, okay? Since you can't afford an attorney, the court will appoint one for you. Do you understand these rights?
Yeah, I know what you're saying, but I'm no sinner. If it's a sinner you want, why don't you arrest Chuck Lee? I'm no saint, but I'm sure no sinner.
Oh, not to the judge. All rise. Hear ye, the Lord, the mighty one, who summons the earth and the heavens above the earth to judge his people.
Be seated.
Your Honor, our first case today is the State versus Ms. Jess Goodenough. She is being charged with being a known sinner and constantly falling short of God's will for her life.
How does the defendant plead?
Your Honor, I plead not guilty.
Ms. Goodenough, where is your defense attorney?
Well, I kind of figured I'd defend myself.
You are aware if you so desire, a public defender will be appointed to help you, aren't you?
Yeah, thanks. I won't need one.
Well, that's your decision then. How do you plead? Not guilty?
Not guilty. I intend to prove to this court that I am basically a good girl. A nice person. Hey, at heart, I'm no worse than anybody else.
Are you sure you won't take the public defender's help?
I don't need anyone's help.
All right, let me remind everyone that the burden of proof lies with the prosecution. The prosecutor must show beyond a shadow of a doubt that Ms. Goodenough has sinned and fallen short of God's desire for her life. But if he succeeds, this court will have no option but to find her guilty and to punish her to the full extent of the law. Is the prosecution ready?
Yes!
Is the defense ready?
Yup.
You may call your first witness.
The defense would like to call Mrs. Paula Hilke to the stand.
Do you swear to tell the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth, so help you God?
I do.
Paula, tell the court how long you've worked with me.
About 10 years.
And in that time, you've seen the quality of work I do?
Yeah, I've seen your work.
And isn't it true that I'm one of the most conscientious women that you've ever worked with, and that I only do top quality work?
That's right. Oh, I remember one time, Jess got mad at the boss because she asked us to do some overtime. She threw her pencil, kicked a chair, screamed at me, pressed the computer, all because of that.
Thank you for the questions.
I mean, she can be grumpy all the time, but she does real good work.
You may step down.
She can throw temper tantrums and be such a royal jerk, but besides all of that, she does real good work.
Objection! I move to strike!
You wish to have the witness's testimony stricken from the record?
No, I wish to strike the witness across her big fat mouth!
Hi, Your Honor. I'd like to have this entered People's Exhibit number 666 for the prosecution.
Do you have any additional questions?
No, Your Honor.
Would the prosecution like to cross-examine?
Yes! Mrs. Hilke, I need to clarify a few points in your testimony. Are you saying that Jess Goodenough is basically a good girl?
Yeah.
That she is essentially a nice person.
Right.
That at heart, she's no worse than anybody else.
That's it.
Would she go as far as to say that Jessica Nuff was perfect?
No, of course she's not, but who is?
Exactly. No further questions.
The witness may step down. You may call your next witness.
The defense would like to call Reverend Dave Letzel to the stand.
It's Letzel.
Do you swear to tell the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth, so help you God?
I do.
Reverend Letzel, will you tell the court if Jess Goodenough was a regular and faithful attender at your church?
Jess Goodenough? Goodenough, you say, huh?
Yes. Tell the court that Jess Goodenough was a regular and faithful member of the church, okay?
Objection, Your Honor. She is leading the witness.
Sustained.
It's me, you idiot!
Objection, Your Honor! Now she is abusing the witness!
Sustained.
Oh, yes, I remember now. You're the girl who sat third pew from the back every Easter and Christmas, correct?
No further questions.
Came 3 Sundays in a row after having your appendix operation in 1994. Five, correct?
Would the prosecution like to cross-examine?
Yes. No.
Okay, the witness may step down. Do you have any additional witnesses to call?
Just one, Your Honor. I'd like to call Mrs. Myrtle Goodenough to the stand.
Do you swear to tell the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth, so help you God?
I do.
Let the record show that Mrs. Goodenough is my own saint of a mother. Mrs. Goodenough, do you recognize this letter?
Oh, yes, dear. That's the letter that I wrote you the year you remembered my birthday.
Your Honor, I'd like to read a portion of this letter and have it entered into Defense Exhibit Number 1. Dear Jess, thank you so much for that lovely birthday present. I am so proud of you and thankful that I have such a wonderful daughter as you. I am constantly bragging to my friends about you and your family. And then it continues on a bit and ends with the words, I love you very much, Mom.
Would the prosecution like to cross-examine?
Yes. I need this correspondence. Thank you. I noticed that you left out part of this letter. I am constantly bragging to my friends about you and your family. Okay, now you read that. But you left out this next part. They all agree that you have really turned your life around. Turned your life around. Turned your life around from what? Isn't it a fact that she hasn't always been a saintly daughter? Isn't it a fact that for most of her miserable life, she was a sickening sack of sordid sin that was a source of sorrow to friends and family?
Well, she's really a good girl.
Really? Like on the night of April 15, 2003, where you had to bail her out of jail for public intoxication?
But...
She's always been a good girl. Then how do you explain the evening of May 7th, 2005, where you're on your knees praying and in tears to God that he would save her from her drugs and drinking?
How did you know about
that? How do you explain the summer of 2006, where for 6 months, 6 days, and 6 hours, you doubted her marriage and even survived?
Nobody's perfect.
You don't say. No further questions.
The witness may step down. Do you have any further witnesses to call?
What for? It's hopeless.
Is there no one who can come to your defense?
I have no defense.
Yes!
Hey, order in the court. I will not tolerate these outbursts from you. Now, if there are no more witnesses for the defense, does the prosecution have any witnesses to call?
I don't need any witnesses.
Well, if there are no further arguments, then I must render a verdict.
Who? Me?
Call for the public defender!
What?
I remind you all that I take no pleasure in this action. Let no one think that I in any way enjoy passing judgment.
You need a public defender!
What's the use?
But as was stated from the beginning, all the prosecution needed to do was establish beyond a shadow of a doubt that Ms. Goodenough has sinned and fallen short of God's will for her life.
He's very, very good!
Why do you call him good?
Sadly enough, it was Ms. Goodenough's own defense that provided all the evidence needed to convict her.
He's never lost a case!
But I'm already lost!
Having listened to all the evidence and concluding that it more than substantiates...
He's the judge's son!
Whoa, wait, hold on, time out a second. Wait.
Ms. Goodenough?
Can I still call for the public defender?
Objection! This case is history. The evidence has been submitted. She is guilty of sin!
You shut your mouth. I will not tolerate these outbursts. Ms. Goodenough, I caution you not to play games with this court. I will not stand for stalling tactics.
No, I knew I made a mistake when I tried to defend myself. I just want to know if there's a chance if I could throw myself in the mercy of the court and call for the public defender.
Okay, call the public defender.
Hello, Ms. Goodenough.
Hi. Boy, am I ever glad to see you. Here, have a seat.
Thank you. Before we get started, I need to know, are you serious about this?
Sure.
No, I mean it. Are you really sincere? Are you ready to entrust me with your entire defense?
Yes.
So you will do everything I ask you to do?
Yes.
Okay, I'm going to have to ask you to change your plea to guilty as charged.
What? Are you crazy? The prosecutor will eat me alive!
Do you trust me?
Okay, what do you want me to do?
I just need you to change your plea to guilty as charged. Your Honor, my client wishes to change her plea.
What?
Ms. Goodenough, do you wish to change your plea?
Yes, sir. Guilty. Guilty as charged.
Guilty? That's your defense? Guilty? So if I say that you're a poor excuse for a saint, you'll say you're...
Guilty.
I'm sorry, I didn't quite catch that.
Guilty!
I still can't hear you!
Guilty!
You're nasty to your co-workers!
Guilty!
You broke your mother's heart!
Guilty!
You're hardly dedicated when it comes to church.
Guilty!
You are a sinner! You're not even close to what God desires in your life!
Guilty, okay? I'm guilty as charged!
I rest my case.
Would the public defender have something to say?
No, Your Honor. I rest my case.
You what? That's my defense? You're guilty as charged and you rest your case?
Don't be afraid. Trust me. I know what I'm doing.
Well, both sides now having presented their case, it becomes my responsibility to render a verdict. The defendant and the counsel will stand for the rendering of the verdict. From the outset, it was understood that to gain a conviction, the prosecutor needed to show beyond a shadow of a doubt that Ms. Goodenough had sinned and fallen short of God's desire for her life. Both the testimony and the evidence showed this to be clear. Ms. Goodenough, the evidence alone would have been enough to convict you, but by your admission of guilt, it becomes easy to make my verdict. I have no choice but to find the defendant guilty as charged. The penalty for this crime is clearly stated. The wages of sin is death. I hereby order that the witness be remanded to the defendant be remanded to the custody of the jailer until time can be made for her execution. Case closed.
But then Jesus arose without freedom.
Thank you, Jesus, for setting me free.